had the radio on. I was driving.
Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to Mr. Austin's Friday P class, my fabulous first graders and my stupendous second graders. It is great to see you. It is great to have you back. It has been great to see you at school. I've mostly been getting a chance to see Mrs. Court's class, but anyway, it's been great to see you. Actually, Mrs. Wells' class. I've been taking those guys, you guys out. Sorry, I keep getting those confused. But anyway, but I know I've seen several of the other classes out there, and I've given you an elbow as we go by. I've been just really enjoying seeing you guys. And like I said last week, that is what fills my bucket. And we're going to continue on with the same thing. That is our caring habit of the week, filling each other's bucket or being a bucket filler. We'll talk about a little bit more about that as we go. I don't want to take a lot of time in the intro here. But we're going to continue on with our throwing. If you can, I'm using just pieces of scrap paper, about four or five pieces of scrap paper. Go ask your parents if you have some laying around. You can use newspaper, scrap paper. Get about four or five sheets of those, and then you could use that. Sorry, I didn't get a chance to send that in a note. I just forgot. Still learning a lot of things with this new system we're doing, and I'm behind on a few things. I haven't been responding to your videos and stuff like that, but I'm trying to get caught up, so please be patient with me. But it's been great, again, to see you. We are going to get right into our, got to fix something on my phone here. Going to get right into our workout. We're doing our stretch. We're doing our body weight workout, and then we are doing our cool down. I've changed the cool down a little bit, and I've also added an exercise in our body weight workout. So it's going to be a little bit more challenging. You guys have done all these exercises, so it won't be too hard. All right, so let's get ready. We're gonna do our good mornings. We're gonna do our squat reach, and we're gonna do our jumping jacks for our warm-ups. And then as we're doing those things, I'll talk about the caring habit of the week. We'll go right into the bodyweight workout and our cool down. And then for our activity, that's what you're gonna need the paper for, our snowball fight, okay? So let's go. Get your water if you need to, but we're gonna do our good mornings. We touch the ground and we reach up. Touch and reach. And reach. And so like I said, we're going to continue on being a bucket filler. And who knows what that means? What does it mean to be a bucket filler? Now the kinders, I went ahead and told them what that meant. You guys, I'm not telling. You guys should know. So I want you to tell me what it means to be a bucket filler. All right? And then the question the thing that I told you guys to do. So let's do our squat reaches. So we squat, we turn, we look back. The thing that I told you guys to do was to go tell somebody in your house, mom or dad, grandma, grandpa, say, tell them, I appreciate you, okay? So that's your assignment to find somebody new. Tell them, maybe you have to call somebody and say, you know what? I really appreciate you. Jumping jacks. Okay, so what does it mean to be a bucket filler? And in that, tell somebody, I appreciate you. I'm thankful for what you do, okay? So that's your caring habit of the week assignment. We're gonna continue on. After this, a body weight workout. Remember, workouts, we don't have to get weights. We don't have to add weights. We just use the weight of our body, okay? So I'm going to get some water before we start. We've added mountain climbers to our, so we have four exercises. So your heart should be beating a little bit better now, a little bit faster than normal, but not, remember, that's just a warm up, kind of get the muscles. And now when we do our body weight workout, the first 20 seconds, you're going as fast as or hard as you can, like the HIIT workout, but the whole workout is different. And so we're gonna do shoulder taps, squat jumps, push-ups, mountain climbers, and then we'll talk about the recovery exercise in between those, okay? So let me get my timer set. And, I knew how to, okay, 20 seconds of shoulder taps. Remember, it's a plank, straight body down the ground, and we're just reaching up, touching each shoulder as many times as we can, as fast as we can. Okay, so let's get ready. Go. Keep your back straight. Keep your glutey from going up or down too much. And tighten your core muscles, your stomach muscles. Tighten those. That's called engaging your core. All right. Come on, guys. 5 more seconds. You can do this. All right. Now, for our recovery, we're going to do our lunge with a twist. We lunge forward, just like that throwing motion. We lunge forward, and we twist across our body. Remember, when we go down, we should look down and see our leg that is out. If we don't see our leg, we've twisted the wrong way. Okay? If I twist the wrong way, I go over, it's like, oh, no leg. I twisted the wrong way. Okay? So I go over, down, see my leg. Okay? And over, down, see my leg. Okay? So this is mimicking our throwing motion, which is our skill. And we're going to be wrapped up with that skill next week. We're going to be combining some of the skills we've been doing to do some activities, some aiming, some target, some different kind of drills and games, okay? So this is practicing a lunge with a twist. Not real fast. Remember, we're getting the heart rate down, okay? Squat jumps, we squat, we jump up as high as we can. And these will really get your heart going. And so our active recovery is a lot slower. Okay, our glutey kickers, remember? Whew. Those squat jumps, those are like burpees for me. And I know, Regina, you're out there, you said you wanted more burpees. Next week, burpees. So get ready. You should start to feel your heart going down, heart rate. I'm able to breathe a little bit easier now. Able to talk a little bit better. After this, we have 2 more exercises. Gonna get a water break, do our cool down, and then onto our throwing skill, the snowball fight. Okay, push-ups. Remember, if you need to go on your knees, you can go ahead and go on your knees. But second grade, I want you to start trying without going on your knees. As many as you can, even if it's just one. All right. And a boxer bounce. On your toes. No heels touching the ground. And if you want to throw a little punch, that's what boxers do, right? Maybe I should have brought over a punching bag. But it's okay. And a little footwork. Footwork's important. A lot of sports. And you get footwork. So I'm going out a little bit. Sometimes I'm just going like I'm jogging. But then sometimes I'm kicking my legs out, but I'm staying active and bringing my everything down. So after this, mountain climbers, you guys know I'll show you. Before we start, I'll pause it and about 10 more seconds. So I'll pause it, show you how I expect you to do mountain climbers. Okay, remember, I'd rather you start slow and do it right, then go fast and not do it correctly. So I'm gonna pause it for a second. This is our last bodyweight workout, mountain climbers. Okay, again, like a plank, and we can bring it up like this. This is a slow way to do it. We just bring it up, bring our knee up towards the chest. And if you wanna go better, we're gonna go like that, okay? So 2 ways to go. Second grade, you should be starting to go a little faster. But it's not like this. Again, we're just going like that. Back is straight, we bring our knee up. So start slow And then as we progress, we do this, you'll get better. Okay, ready? Here we go. And okay, so if you're going slow, it's just like this, and that's okay. And then as you go faster, you start to go like this. Okay, now we're gonna walk over, I'm gonna walk over, get some water, cool down. And our cool downs are gonna be balancing exercises. I can't stress enough how important it is to have good balance in sports, in PE, and the things we do. So we're gonna balance on one leg for 15 seconds and then balance on the other leg for 15 seconds. And then we're gonna do the bird dog pose, toes, knees, hands, one arm out, and we'll switch, okay? So let me get our timer. Okay, so we'll do a countdown and put that down there and balance on one leg. And if you wanna make it a little tougher, put your hands above your head. If you want to make it real tough, look up while you're balancing. But if you are having a hard time, keep your hands out, look straight ahead. Okay? And if you put your foot down, get your balance, pick it right back up. Okay? Again, balance important. We switch legs. If you forgot, if you didn't hear the beep, switch legs. Remember, if you want to go harder, hands up. Okay, bird dog. Toes, knees, arms straight out. Don't roll over. Keep your head straight, everything straight, and your arm up. Don't let it drift down. Keep it straight, point out. Okay, so this way, other arm is gonna look like this. Okay, remember, not like this, but like this, straight ahead. And I'm balancing on my fingertips, so technically I've got toes, knees, fingertips, so. All right, so that's our good cool down. Now, if you need to take a break, you need to pause it, go ahead. That's all right. But what we're gonna do is, if you were able to find some scrap paper, you're gonna wad it up nice and tight, not loose, okay? We're gonna wad it up nice and tight so that it fits in our hand. If it's loose, it won't, we can't throw it very well. Now, if you don't have, if you can't get any, check with your parents and be like, oh, you know what, we didn't plan on it today. That's okay. You can always do it later, or if, whatever ball that you have. You should have a ball by now that fits in your hand, okay? Not a basketball, because I can't get the proper grip. If you're not doing the proper grip, then we gotta go back and find a ball that fits in our hand. This is a very small ball, so I've got two fingers and then my thumb, okay? So I want you to grip it like that. My hand over here are kind of guides, but if I have a bigger ball, maybe three fingers, but we don't throw like this. We don't grip it like this. So, but today, so grab our paper. And I got about 60 here, so I'm just gonna make some and wad them up in nice little tight balls. Okay. And we talked about this on Monday and Tuesday, the proper steps to throwing. Still the same, just like for underhand throwing, overhand throwing, same way. And some of you have already demonstrated this for me. Great. But we want to be able to really proficient, we want to be mastering both techniques. Underhand step, swing, throw, and then overhand step. And this was our archer pose, remember? It's like I'm pulling back a bow, I'm stepping forward, and I'm going across, and my hand is coming here like that. It's lunge with a twist, my hand is coming across my body, and it's gonna end up over here in my pocket. But remember, the step with the opposite foot, coming across, and not like so. This means standing like this and throwing would be totally wrong. That would be maybe like a one or a two, all right? Stepping like this with the wrong foot and throwing, that would be two, that would be definitely a solid two, okay, if I were grading, if you were back in school. And then stepping with the correct, the opposite foot, your correct foot, and throwing but not twisting, that might be kind of not quite a three, but close. You're getting closer. But a three is stepping, twisting, and throwing, okay? And you couldn't see that, so that's why I want to get lots of pieces of paper so I can hold them and step, swing, throw. I'm looking at my target. When I go, I point at my target, step, swing, throw, okay? And then this just makes it easier having a bunch of paper like this. It makes it easier. And you guys can use a wall or a couch if you're inside with nice light balls. If you're outside, check with your parents. Maybe you can use the wall or the side of the fence or something, just where you can step, swing, throw, and really get good at letting that, releasing the ball and kind of letting it roll off your fingers. We don't throw it like that. We don't push it forward. We bring it back and we kind of nice and gently let it roll there. So that's your assignment for this Friday. That's your assignment for today. Have a great day. I'll see you next week. And like I said, hopefully I'm gonna get back on track and get everything, all my stuff caught up, and we will be playing a different game, a bowling game next week, okay? I love you boys and girls. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.